I'm not quite sure how to begin this letter. You've all touched me at one time or another in my short life. That said, for reasons I don't expect you to understand, I will soon no longer be here. I woke up Tuesday morning with what I thought was an unfortunate patch of dry skin on my forearm. After drying off in the shower, I applied some moisturizer and continued on with my day. However, not long after, I encountered the first of a bizarre string of events that in summation could only logically lead to one possible outcome: my imminent zombification. While extending my hand to pick up my double-double steep tea, I allowed my forearm to become exposed to a glance of another patron picking up his beverage of choice. Upon his glance, he commented, "What bit ya?" Odd, I thought at first, that he would feel it in his place to interject with such an obtuse comment. "What, do you work here?" I thought to myself. But the searing comment of a complete stranger consumed my mind for the rest of the afternoon. Soon my forearm began to itch, then burn. Within a couple of hours, all I could think of was the festering, bubbling, oozing, infected boil which was quickly taking over my entire forearm. The venom of some sort of super virus that was surely pulsing through my arm was taking over every living cell. Just when I could not fathom my situation getting any more hellish.
Hey, Tom.
It did.
Good. I'm tired.
How long's it been since you slept? There was no denying that life was being sucked out of me. As if the giant bags under my eyes were a clear indication in themselves, the fatigue I felt was a sure sign that something within me was gravely wrong. I decided to grab a random flick and throw it on, just to soothe my shaky nerves. But fate would have its filthy hands on the seemingly innocent action as well. As I stared at the cathode ray tube, the definitive answer to my series of increasingly alarming warning signs stared right back at me.
What happened to them?
Yes, Doctor. What is all this about the dead coming back to life again and having to be killed a second time? I mean, what the hell's going on here?
You ever heard of voodoo?
Voodoo? Doctor, you gotta be joking.
No, whatever it is, it makes the dead stand up and walk.
I was no doubt becoming a zombie. I decided right then and there that some immediate action was required if I was to have any chance at all of clinging to what remained of my fully conscious mind. Didn't work. I suppose I was just too late. I could feel my mind slipping. The cells decaying. It was too late for me. It is too late for me. After coming to grips with this, I decided to begin to normalize myself to the zombie lifestyle. I figure that when I wake up dead tomorrow, this way it will not be such a shock to the system. I will have a sense of an established routine that I can live out until the impending time when my brain will be destroyed by someone who has not yet joined the leagues of the undead that I will surely have been a part of starting. I apologize for that. That said, I also apologize in advance if one day in the near or distant future you find yourself being eaten by me. I can only assume that by the time you read this letter, I will have already switched over. So on that note, do not attempt to visit me and see if I'm okay. The last thing I want to do is to have to eat a loved one's brains to sustain myself. Well, I suppose that's it.